Hello, I'm Susan Saldivar, and welcome to Inside Cinema. Inside Cinema is an intimate look into the lives of Hollywood's most creative artists who are making movies today. In this episode, you'll meet the Academy Award-winning composer, Jan A.P. Kaczmarek. The power of the film score cannot be underestimated, and the role of the composer is probably one of the most independent of all creative roles in filmmaking. Jan will share with us his approach to the complex art of composing for film. I met Jan in Santa Monica, California. The evening brought together Jan's friends and close collaborators, as well as others who would experience his music and discover his fascinating journey from growing up behind the Iron Curtain in Poland to becoming a celebrated composer in Hollywood. I was thrilled to escort Jan, his lovely wife Elise Biata, and son Simone into the TV Authority showroom. Awaiting Jan was close friend, award-winning director Agnieszka Holland, who has collaborated with Jan on such films as Total Eclipse, Washington Square, and The Third Miracle. In February of 2005, Jan was honored with the Academy Award for Best Original Score for his work in Finding Neverland. For you, how does that creative process begin?
Well, let's start from my first contact with the film is the most important. I'm very emotional how I react, and if film has a quality in it which appeals to me, I immediately respond emotionally, and this is the most important moment. Then the music starts in my head, not necessarily the same second, but it does start the process. The most important part of my writing always happens as a result of my instinctive relationship with the picture. And then my other part of my brain is switched on, and I deal with what I produced, and I start to creating structure. Process has two stages, stage of instinct at work, and then the structure being constructed.
What do you feel about when they put in a temp track?
If there's an openness of both sides, temp track is not such a terrible thing. It can serve as an additional tool for communication between us. But sometimes temp track becomes a nightmare when director and other people get so attached to it after weeks and weeks of listening that they cannot imagine anything different. I never try to copy temp track because this ends up with a disaster always. The closer you get, the more obvious is you are not there. So it's much more practical and much more ambitious and much more creative to go for your own solution.
Lost Souls was directed by his fellow countryman, Academy Award winner Janusz Kaminski, starring Winona Ryder and John Hurt.
Father. Why are we doing this?
In composing Finding Neverland, Jan found the actual scoring duties on the film more complex. Jan said there were three lines developing in the material. First, the psychological, interactive music, music connecting people, and then there was the music for the fantasy world of James Barry, and thirdly was the play itself.
The end title credits to Finding Neverland, it's absolutely beautiful what you composed. And can you tell us a little bit about the pianist that performed on that piece?
His name is Leszek Możdżer. He's probably the most famous pianist in Poland now. I needed for end credit something extremely, extremely, extremely gentle and extremely kind. You may remember the last scene is sit on the bench when Johnny Depp with a little boy, they sit on the bench, and it was such a moving scene. And what can you play after? Only something which is extremely subtle. So I chosen the piano piece for it, and having Leszek as a perfect medium for it. I was very optimistic about the result.
Just believe.
I can see her.
Now
Now, there was a piece that you composed for a play, Tis Pity, She's a Whore, mm-hmm. and I understand you were able to use that in Washington Square in a wedding scene as well.
That was actually great way of using something which I created years ago when I just arrived to the United States, and I was basically unemployed at the time, and theater was the only avenue for my creativity. So I wrote enormous amount of music, very ambitious scores, which you never write for dramatic theater in this country, but I did it anyway, even some of them were never used. So Tis Pity, She's a Whore was exceptional play because it was very visual. You don't have many plays like this being staged in America. Joanna Kalaitis, the director, is famous of making theater almost like a movie. It means very visual, full of wonderful images and a lot of space for the music. So between dialogue, you have sometimes minutes of vision, and I used it very properly. But still, having written music for that particular piece of theater, when I had Washington Square in front of me, I thought this is a perfect piece, which is waiting there, used only once. And we need the song, and I use the song again.
Lastly, you have 4 children.
Yes.
Are they musical as well, or did you pass that on to them?
They all demonstrated certain level of talent, but they all refused to practice. So we were going every 3 years, because each of them is 3 years younger than the other. We were going through the same moment of confrontation and total rejection. They rejected the idea of practicing piano. So 4 times I was defeated on that front.
Jan may have been defeated on that front, but his triumph has been his music, inspiring all of us to pursue our dreams. His warmth and passion was felt by so many people. I was touched by his genuine kindness. I thank Jan A.P. Kaczmarek for making it such a memorable evening. I'm excited and looking forward to the places that Jan will take us, places that we've yet to discover.